Now, let's do some exercises to test our knowledge. So, the first exercise we have is why management principles should be studied. What is the need for studying these principles? So, as I explained you, it helps to provide insight to the managers. Okay. It helps in optimum utilization of resources in the organization. Lastly, it helps in taking scientific decisions, which again help in achieving the organizational goals in a proper manner. Next, it helps to fulfill the social responsibilities. See, whenever an organization is working, as I explained you earlier, they need to work in a society. So they need to work with the society, for the society, and not against the society. So that social responsibility also gets fulfilled when management principles are studied. Okay, now let's do exercise number 2. See, objective of motion study. What is the objective of motion study? That is the question that is being asked. So as we have studied, it helps to determine and eliminate unnecessary movements in the organization. Now, the next is we have been asked to provide 2 causes of fatigue. As I explained you, if there are long working hours or if there are uncordial relation with the workers or with the managers. That is, if the manager and the workers do not have cordial relation, it will lead to fatigue. Now, what is the objective of time study? Obviously, to determine the standard time to perform a defined job. Let's do exercise number 3. Now, see, the question here is, which principle of management resembles military organization? Okay, so we have been asked this question. Now, here the answer is unity of command. If you remember, we studied that under unity of command, whatever is the command which has been given has to be followed and it has to come from one source. So that is why it resembles the military organization. Now, who has developed the general principles of management? I explained you this already. It was Henry Fayol. Okay. Now, what are the principles of scalar chain? See, as I explained you, it forms a line of authority. If you remember that triangle which we did, so it forms a line of authority and communication from highest to lowest ranks. Now, let's do the next exercise. So we have been asked to distinguish between Henry Fayol and Taylor. Okay, so we need to understand how they were different from each other. See, in terms of perspective, Henry Fayol was interested in management. He was interested more in managers, especially the top level management. Here, F.W. Taylor was more interested in workers. So, he was more interested in the shop level of a factory. The applicability of the Henry Fayol management principles was universal. Taylor, for whatever he suggested in terms of the principles he brought in, they were applicable for specialized situation. What was the basis of information for Henry Fayol? It was personal experience. For Taylor, it was observation and experimentation. If you remember, I told you he experimented and observed in his company in which he was working. Now, what about focus? See, Fayol always focused on improving the overall administration in the company. Here, Taylor focused on productivity, improving the productivity, increasing the productivity. In terms of status, as I already told you, Fayol is said to be the father of general management. Here, Taylor is said to be the father of scientific management. In terms of personality, he was a practitioner. That is, Fayol was a practitioner, but Taylor was a scientist. Now, let's do the next exercise. So, what we have been given is about a company, RJ Limited. RJ Limited attaches no importance to suggestions given by subordinates. So the work culture out there is the managers are really not interested in whatever suggestions are being given by the subordinates. Now, they have appointed a CEO who is a MBA. So he has an MBA degree. Now, the name of the CEO is Mr. KD. What does this KD does? KD ran a campaign wherein he invited suggestions from employee. And he went ahead and shortlisted 500 suggestions for further review. After that, he implemented some of the reviews or suggestions which were being given. Post review, he implemented some suggestions. Because of that, the company earned 150 crores. So that is the case study all about. Now, the question being asked is, which principle of management was adopted. Now you have the example, so you can think about the principle. As you can see here, the principle of initiative has been adopted. Why? Because KD took an initiative to ask the employees to provide suggestions to improve the operations. Okay, now what are the two positive effects of this particular principle? See, first thing, it increases the thinking process, creativity and innovativeness. When an employee was being asked to improve, to suggest the improvements, he went ahead and thought about different ways in which a particular thing can be improved. So that resulted in creativity and innovativeness among employees. Next, it improves the sense of attachment to the organization, because a senior person, senior management had asked you to do something which has some value, and hence as an employee you feel that recognition is being given to you, and hence you feel a sense of belongingness.